Boy! People sleep on this Pac song right here, G.
G.
People sleep on this joint.
Pac used to love to rap, G.
Yeah.
We got like four verses.
This four, bruh, I'm about to talk about that.
I'm like, dang, G!
Yo, welcome to Beers and Bars, your place for rapid fire hip hop discussion and, of course, great beer.
I am Kamal Kiddo.
OT the Golden Child. Thank y'all for checking out our last episode. Big shout out to Bink. Binky, right? I always say it. I say yep. Bink, Binky. I'm tripping.
Bink, Binky.
Yeah. And Alarmist Brewery. You know what I'm saying? We did the last show was there. So shout out to Gary over there and the whole staff. You know what I'm saying? For letting us come through. Make sure you check out Alarmist Brewery. They do their thing here in Chicagoland area. You know what I'm saying? Check them out.
What are we doing today?
So today, man, we are going to do something different. We have always talked about, you know, releasing playlists or doing a playlist and all that.
Yeah.
So what we're going to do here today with the homie Eddie P in the background, we're going to, we actually curated a playlist.
Hey, what's up, bro?
What would you call this? What did I name this?
The playlist of utmost importance.
Yeah, so I think
I can dig it. I dig it.
Majority of the songs on the playlist, yeah, I think, are important to both of us. Yeah. And we're going to have a live little session here where we talk about the songs on the playlist,
yeah,
while ADP spins them in the background.
Yeah.
And then when the show airs, we will release the playlist to you, and you.
Yeah, so when you watch this, you can log off and do
yeah,
go play this on
exactly
Apple Music.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Beer for today.
Yes, what are we drinking?
Today we are drinking.
Oh, also, yeah, we're also talking about, we're doing a playlist, and
Royce the 5'9".
Royce the 5'9", new album, The Allegory.
It's The Allegory, yeah.
It's just called The Allegory?
Just called The Allegory,
I thought
yeah
it was like something like...
I believe extra. It's just called The Allegory, but we can check on that real quick.
Yeah, The Allegory. The Allegory.
Right. Yeah.
Royce the 5'9", The Allegory.
Today we are drinking Cain and Abel from Two Brothers. This is a red rye IPA, which is why I grabbed it. Because I'm like, I never had a rye IPA. Let's see. Let's
dig it. It's not as hoppy.
So, fan favorite Chicago's crab. Well, here's the thing about it. Supposedly, the rye gives it a little bit different flavor. So rye is a cereal grain. Usually, you find it in flour or different types of bread. You have whiskey that's distilled in rye.
Yeah.
But this IPA was brewed with rye. All right. So... this is their Two Brothers signature, call it what you want, but there's no denying Cain and Abel's a true original. With this unique hybrid style, this red rye IPA balances the distinct creamy sweetness of Thai palm sugar with a crisp bitterness caused by some pretty wacky hop combinations, and is rounded by a smooth, dry finish. What are you thinking? How do you feel about it?
I can dig it. I can definitely taste the rye.
Yeah.
So
rye, like, supposedly
the hop.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Let me see.
There's a faint distinction and difference as far as like a regular IPA.
Yeah. Yeah. You know, so supposedly the rye grain gives it a different kind of character as far as the flavor is concerned.
No, I can dig it.
And I can taste the Thai palm sugar. It does have like a sweetness at the end of it.
Yeah.
But this joint is good. I'm a fan of their Wobble IPA. We've had that on the show before. Honestly, I kind of went with this because I haven't had Two Brothers in a while. It's one of my intro to craft beer breweries.
For sure.
You know what I'm saying?
For sure.
So, but shout out to Two Brothers.
Shout out to Two Brothers. What's up?
Yeah, y'all in Warrenville.
Where y'all
I
at?
Live close to Warrenville. I'm in KO Stream.
True that, man.
What the F and H?
We need to go check them out.
Yeah, man. Actually, let me get a location out real quick. Let me go ahead and plug y'all real quick if you are in the area. They are located. I don't know if this is West, but 30W315 Calumet Road.
It's at 30W.
Yeah, I don't. Is that 30 West 315? I don't know. 30W315 Calumet Avenue, Warrenville, Illinois. That's where their tap house is. So check them out. Eddie P. Again, this is the playlist of utmost importance. So Eddie P. gonna play some
we
stuff.
We got Eddie P. on the ones and twos.
All right. So Eddie P. whatever you want to do. What's first?
So we did. So here's the thing. We both did 5 songs apiece.
Yeah.
10 songs total.
Yes.
For this playlist.
Yes.
We just going to rapid fire this joint. Talk about, you know, these songs real quick.
Yeah. ADP, we'll do about 2 minutes, 3 minutes of each song. So Let's what's that first joint? If y'all don't know what this is one of my selections. All right, let's do it like this. This is Straight Ballin', Thug Life Volume 1.
Bring it down just a little bit.
Thug Life Volume 1. It came out in 1994. The reason why I chose this song is because it's very important to my childhood. I was 11 when this came out, and I never was a street dude at all. But this song made me feel like I knew what it was to, you know what I'm saying? Well, first of all, I'm born on the West Side, so I'm familiar with, you know what I'm saying, certain elements of being from, you know what I'm saying, where we are from and whatnot. But this song is Pac giving you that passionate, you know what I'm saying, the passionate tales of the hood, of a street dude and whatnot. That passionate flow that we love Pac for, you know what I'm saying? This was the Thug Life Volume 1 album, I believe, in which there was only one album. It's him and four other dudes, I believe. Three other dudes. Huh? No, this was not the Outlaw. So Thug Life, actually, check it out. Thug Life was supposed to be Pac, Macadocious, Mo Preem, and the Rated R. Thinking about this, I always thought this song was on a soundtrack. But this was an actual album that was from 94.
I remember the Thug Life album, but I thought it was...
I could be wrong. I thought the Outlaws... Maybe this is. I don't know. I wasn't really... I just remember this song because my cousins and my sister was playing it a lot. And I was 11. I ain't know nothing. But all I knew was, when my niggas in the penitentiary, reload, cuff. Like, that's all I knew was, like, gee, this is the hardest song I've ever heard
that's
in my life.
Up.
So,
that's
but yeah. Up. That's why I chose this, because it's very important to my childhood. I was 11 years old and I was in love with this song, even though I was not a gangster at all.
True.
But I wanted to be one.
True.
Listening to this song.
Next song.
ADP, next song. What we got, man?
True.
Oh. Bring it all up. There we go. This is you? Y'all sleep on this. I know they're not gonna know it.
All right, so shout out to my guy Julian.
Mm-hmm.
Ju working on projects. He put me on Tame Impala, on Currents, the last album that came 2014. Out. 2014.
Yeah.
Which is his last album. He came back in 2020.
Yeah.
With The Slow Rush.
Yes.
Which I think is an even better album.
Ooh. You know what I'm saying? One guy. Well, two guys, but this one guy mainly does all of the...
mainly one guy.
Right.
But Kevin Parker. But he does all the instruments.
Yeah.
Right?
Correct.
So,
what's the name of this song?
This song, though, is called...
Breathe Deeper.
Breathe Deeper.
Mm-hmm.
And it's probably the most jamming song on the album.
Yeah, for sure. If y'all not up on Tame Impala,
I'm a big fan of Tame. If you listen to Rihanna, her last on Anti, she covered one of Tame's songs from Currents. I forget what the name of the song is,
right.
But it's on there. You know what I'm saying? I forget. Okay. But Tame Impala, Breathe Deeper, man. This hit me because I like Tame. This is the latest new album. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying?
And it's one of the current joints on this joint.
Yeah.
That's dope.
Yeah.
Okay.
I like that, Ed. I like that.
We back to me. Just hold on.
That her mother said she won't see her father, and this before he did a year when them charges was brought up. I shook my head, turned around, and found a hundred.
Okay, bring it down. I first heard this song in 2012. This is His Pain, which is actually on BJ the Chicago Kid's album, called Pineapple Now and Later, so something like that.
Yeah, that's it.
It's just such a great. It's like a spiritual, like, doubt song almost. It's like Kendrick is going through these verses talking about, I'm being blessed, but I'm recognizing, or he's looking at people who are not being blessed, or he's like, dang, why am I so fortunate? and I'm seeing all this calamity within my neighborhood. This is going on.
Things
that he's going doing right.
The wrong that he's doing.
Exactly. But yes, but yet he's still
around him.
Yeah.
But he's getting blessed.
Right.
It's pretty dope.
It's a dope. It's just a deep song. It came out in 2012.
I've never heard it until today, G.
And what I like the most about the song, why I really picked it, is because on the third verse, he's like, G, the reason why I'm being blessed is so I can bless you, G.
Now I know why he
now
keep
I know why
me.
He keep now blessing
me. Now
I
know me. Why. This man spit, G.
Bruh. And that's just such a great outlook to me, because people is shitty to other people, G. Like, what would happen? What would the world be if people was just, like, nicer to other people, G? Like, people don't have a genuine appreciation for other people. Like, I don't want to get too deep, you know what I'm saying? But
I was just about to go there. I was just about to be on some rap music, G.
Yeah.
Rap music,
yeah.
G.
Yeah.
Dog, rap music, G.
Now I know why he keep blessing. Yeah, man. Yeah.
Yeah. It's a connector, man.
Yeah, man. For real, for real. That's why I chose this. This song is very important to me. Oh. Up. Up. What we doing, Kamal?
So.
Hey.
All right, so check it.
Okay.
Tears. The song is Tears from 1993.
Yeah.
From the 1993 album, Wu-Tang's first debut album.
Yeah.
36 Chambers.
Yes.
This is important for me because I'm a major Wu-Tang fan. Y'all should know that by now.
Yeah.
This song in particular, though, when I was a shorty, I was probably in... I heard this when I was in high school.
Yeah.
I heard this when I was in high school. It came out in 93, but I wasn't up on Wu yet.
Right.
So when I heard it, I'm like, yo, first of all, the beat itself had me wanting to learn how did they do this? You know
what
I'm
saying? The sample from? Do you know?
I forget the name of the song. But it's a sample.
Yeah.
And when I heard the sample, like, this song made me want to get into production. Because this is the sample. I'm like, yo, what is this?
Right.
This is crazy.
Exactly.
So then, especially Ghost's verse.
Yeah.
Is about, like, real world stuff.
Yeah,
you know
Ghost was spitting on this joint, G.
Like, when they say, like, Wu-Tang is for the babies, Wu-Tang is for the children, G.
Yeah.
They was really on some New York rapping, but really trying to give you jewels, G.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Really, like, cautionary tales, G.
Yeah.
I don't know, man.
Yeah.
Tears, man.
Tears, man. Y'all should know that, too, G. We going right to you again.
This is me.
Yeah.
So.
Y'all, some of these y'all should be familiar with. Y'all know what this is.
They might not know this joint, though.
They should. The Love Movement, right?
So, this is, the song Against the World by a Tribe Called Quest, by their probably lesser known album, I'm gonna say, The Love Movement, which
1998,
also had,
baby,
which also had the major hit Now You Caught My Heart for the Evening.
Yeah, exactly.
Moved in,
and this song kind of is in that flavor too.
In that flavor. Yeah. So the whole album is in this flavor. Mm-hmm. The whole album is on some love type stuff.
Mm-hmm.
I like this song in particular because of the cadence of how they rap it. You know what I'm saying? I always like this song. And
it's very playful, the flows, how they jumping in and out.
I think it explains, or this is like quintessential Tribe.
It is.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like they playing with
yeah.
It's like how they JD mm-hmm. on production. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. It's a vibe, man.
Like, it's a vibe, G. You know what I'm saying? And I just want to throw it in there.
Shatown stepping to this joint.
Because, I mean, like, I go back. Like, this is not considered one of their best albums.
Yeah.
But I go to it a lot.
It's a
just
sleeper,
vibe-y.
Though.
This album is a sleeper to me.
Yeah.
It's a vibey album, G. It's a chill.
It's a vibe, yeah.
But, yeah, G.
Okay. Next song, what we got, man?
That's you, G.
It's me? Stop playing. Mind playing tricks on me. Ghetto Boys, 1991. Classic. I don't gotta say a lot about this.
True.
Willie D's verse is the first verse I ever memorized. I make big money, I drive big cars, everybody know me. It's like I'm a movie star, but late at night, something ain't right. I feel I'm being trailed by the same sucker's heads. Like, isn't that, you know what I'm saying? Like, that's the first verse I ever remember. And this is one of the best storytelling hip hop joints of all time. To me. I was 8 years old and I was in love with this joint. So it's definitely important to me as far as, again, one of those songs, like the Pac joint, that I really remember from my childhood. So
this video was scary, though.
Fam, Bushwick Bill, rest in peace, right? He passed away, right?
I think so.
Yeah. He used to scare me, G, because I didn't understand, like, who is this little dude, man? Who is this little wild dude, G? I was scared to do.
Crazy eye. The patch over his eye.
Yeah, man. Yeah, for real, for real.
Yeah, that was, he was a little scary.
For real.
This video was a little scary.
Yeah. Well, I mean, yeah, it's
shorty. It was a little scary.
Guarantee if you ask people about songs that's important to them, that will probably make it.
True.
This you. We back at you right now.
Alright. Friday.
Yeah. This joint is fire.
I will rock this microphone always. So check it. NF Doom.
Yeah.
Probably one of his better productions. Mm-hmm. I mean, he's a good producer, but one of his better productions. And, you know what I'm saying? He was rapping crazy on here, but I like it because he got some lines in here.
Yeah.
But
he's a wordsmith.
Yeah, G. He is a super ho.
And this is 1999. Right. Yeah. So our junior year, right?
Debut album. This is from his debut album, Operation Doomsday. It's like one of the last songs on the album. It's a Isaac Hayes sample, if you can tell. I don't know what else to say, man. He did his thing on here. He's a playful rapper. The video for Dead Bent. This name of the song is Dead Bent. Look up the video. Shout out to Michelle Gondry because he bit off of Michelle Gondry and it's like a two-frame joint.
Yeah.
And then like one.
Bro.
You got to see it. You got to see it.
I ain't going to lie. I hear.
The Dead Bent, MF Doom.
I hear a lot of what you did in college as far as production that joint. You know what I'm saying?
For sure.
I know it's important to you.
For sure.
Moving on though. I know y'all sleep on this joint, G.
Oh yeah, I almost didn't recognize this when I was listening to it, dude.
10 minutes. 10 minutes alone. Alright, so this is Joe Budden from the album Joe Budden, I think 2003. The song is called 10 Minutes. I don't from an introspective open book type rapper standpoint, I don't think Joe Budden get enough credit. To me,
you don't rap like this no more.
Drake, to me, does like, Drake is like, you know what I'm saying, he's the love songs and all that kind of stuff, but like a lot of what he do, to me, is patterned like on like what Joe do. Joe is very much an open book, always have been.
Very vulnerable.
That's thank you for that word.
But
for that word.
He don't rap like this no more. He's more biting he's more like poking the bear now, mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? He's not this Joe anymore. You know what I'm saying? This is a different Joe than what he is now.
Yeah,
you
for sure.
You know what
I'm saying? This song was important to me at this time because me as an MC, I try to be an open book. And like songs like this kind of mature me as far as like being vulnerable, G. Like people relate to your vulnerability. Your story.
For sure.
And this is like 10 minutes of him just venting.
Yeah. Yeah. For sure.
So Joe, when we tag you, retweet this, and then bring us on the podcast so we can argue with your hoof at. But no, yeah,
my
Joe Budden.
Kamal, man. Get the other Kamal up.
Yeah, man. But y'all know what it is, man. 10 minutes, Joe Budden. Moving on. What's next?
Grave Diggers.
1994.
So this sample, I don't know where it comes from, but it's also something that Ali Shaheed Muhammad sampled for Tribe.
Spirit but fire.
I don't know if Prince Paul did this or RZA did this, produced it, because Prince Paul was working with Dayla. Of course,
Nowhere to RZA. Run, nowhere to hide. Yeah.
Yeah. So RZA's in the group. Prince Paul's in the group.
Yeah.
There's like two other members. I can't think of their name.
Yeah.
But I threw this on there because I saw a tweet that RZA put out about the Grave Diggers album. I knew they existed, but I never checked for them for real. You know what I'm saying? So I threw it on, and this is their first album.
Yeah.
And this one song kind of stood out. It's like the second or third song on that album. And I'm like, this kind of. This is classic 90s rap.
It's very much so classic 90s.
You know what I'm saying? 90s. And this is very, like, they playing with their voice.
Yeah.
With a hit, with a hum.
With a hum, with a hum.
Like, yeah. Once again, G, rap music, G.
It's good.
Hip-hop music. You can take a canvas and just paint on it whatever you want to do, G. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? There's no rules to this, G. There's no rules to it.
Yeah.
I love it.
Yeah.
I love it.
I dig that joint too, man. But I was bumping the playlist and I was like, oh, I never heard this before.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Ending out the playlist.
The thieves sing. Play me at night, they won't act right.
I don't gotta talk.
Like a crack pipe. No mind at the base.
I don't have to talk. I don't wanna.
Happy Nathan with Pimps. I'm in.
This is my favorite. This is possibly my favorite song of all time.
Mm. He's been. That
sounds terrible. P. Rock killed this joint.
He did.
The storytelling, the vision. It's so much happening.
Yeah.
I sipped the Don P. watching Gandhi. Watching Gandhi until I'm charged. Gandhi got you inspired. Now I'm writing in my book of rhymes. All my words I passed the margin. To hold the mic, I'm throbbing, mechanical. I'm fanboying out right now. Ill will, God bless your life. Like, what? God bless your
life.
Baby pictures. Mm. It's just too much happening.
Aiming guns in all my baby pictures.
Hold on, right here. Golden Child. Now you know where it come from. Mm. The movie and... Yeah, we done. Man, we ain't gotta do that no more, cause Ed can do it. Give us a horn. That's the playlist of utmost importance.
Check it. Available now on streaming now on Apple Music.
Recently, Royce the 5'9" Detroit MC dropped an album called The Allegory.
Yeah.
I like Royce a lot at this point. I feel like his music is as good as it's ever been. Layers made my top five in 2016. I like Book of Ryan in 2018. I like Respect the Shooter mixtape. Prime 1 was fire. Prime 2. How you feel about this album? How you feel?
So, you know, I know that Royce the 5'9 is a very good rapper.
Self-produced album too, yeah. Huh? This one.
What you mean by that?
He made the album. He produced his album.
What you mean by that? He made the beats?
Yeah.
No, he didn't.
Yeah.
You lying, Jay.
I'm not lying.
Are you for real?
I'm dead serious.
I got to look into that. He a producer?
Yeah.
Are you for real?
Yeah. Go, keep going. Yeah, I'll look it up while you... Yeah.
I was 36 years old on February 25th when I found out that Royce the 5'9 is a producer.
Yeah, man. Yeah.
Wow. I say that to say this. I've heard a lot of Royce the 5'9 projects.
Yeah.
I think he's good. I think he's a more palatable Lupe in the sense that he's Lupe be spitting.
Yeah.
But he's extra heady. And I gotta like understand and gotta like read books to understand what he's saying.
Yeah.
But Royce, I get everything.
Yeah.
But he's just as heady. But not as heady.
Yeah.
If you feel what I'm saying.
I understand where you're coming from. Yeah.
So, this is one of my, I'm going to say this is my favorite Royce project to this point. Dude. Yeah.
Don't age. Fire.
Mainly because of the beats.
Yeah.
But I think it was a little ambitious. He, like,
too many songs to me. For me.
It's a lot of songs.
22 songs.
And the musical things he's doing, the musical things done on here are very, like, up and down and, like, it's not always in the pocket. You know what I'm saying? Like, he'll have something like this going.
Yeah.
And then it'll break with, like, you know, a crazy radio skit or something, and then go back to it. You know what I'm saying? And it's just like,
it's weird, yeah.
It's kind of weird in that aspect, but
shout out to JR Bang of Some Dude Podcast made the same point. Yeah.
Yeah, like, bro be rapping though, G. And he made a lot of good points on this album. I gotta go Google Sarah Bartman. I gotta go Google the Rhinestone do-rag. He's right about Louis C.K. will say that in front of Chris Rock, but he won't say that in front of D.L. Hughley.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? It's a lot of memorable lines on here.
It is.
You know what I'm saying? I always felt like, man, G, if you a rapper, you can't tell another rapper. If you were like a quote-unquote mumble rapper, that's part of the art, G. Mm-hmm. You can't say that their art is lesser than yours.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yes.
Now, I come from a different era where I grew up on backpack rap and like 3-6.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
But I feel Royce when he's saying like, bruh, yeah, you own your masters, but what is that?
What's gonna last?
Like, your music don't stand the test of time.
I ain't gotta talk on this segment. You
like
you
doing I feel it. What he's saying. You know what I'm saying? I feel what he's saying. And I normally don't like rappers like that.
Yeah.
Bro, just do your art.
He sounds like an elder. He sounds like
But he sounds like an elder. Yes. That's
genuine.
That's genuine and telling you. He's telling you what it is, you know what I'm saying? Shout out, I don't know the Instagrammer's name.
Men lie, numbers lie. Wait, no, men lie, women lie.
He was getting and at somebody, but too. I don't know who he's getting at. There's a couple of lines on here directed at somebody.
Dude. That's a fire. Let me tell you why that's fire. Because, and no disrespect to this guy, but Post Malone did numbers last year, G.
He did. Did he?
Yes. Kill.
He did. I'm gonna say
he won the best hip hop album of the year on some award show. Did we review him? We don't really check for dude. That's no diss. But even he himself have said, Joe, I'm not really a rapper.
He's not.
But if you looked at numbers and people consider him hip hop, oh, he killing it. He the best.
Almost.
You see what I'm saying? But Royce ain't gonna do numbers. But gee, I'm not finna put on Post over Royce though.
Facts.
Royce jumping up for me right now at this point. Like,
this is the Instagrammer I was talking about. I don't know his name, but I've seen these videos. Matter of fact, I know who he is. Mm-hmm. Dude with the tats on his face, dreads from Miami.
Yeah.
Or Florida, or wherever you're from. I don't know where you're from. Mm-hmm. But
I dig the album overall. I like a lot of the
shout
concept.
Out to Griselda. Cause they all, every one of them over there.
All we did was slang dope.
All we did was slang dope.
Benny got off.
Westside did his
Westside
thing.
Westside got off. Conway got off. I like the album. I like the whole album.
I ain't gonna front. I like it.
Is it my favorite? Possibly.
It's my favorite of Royce.
Still might be my number one, but I don't know. Royce. But I really dig this. I'm glad that Royce put this out. I'm glad that we got a good boom bap traditional hip hop album, you know what I'm saying, from this guy.
He's another vulnerable rapper, G.
Exactly.
He talked about some things like the last song, My Hero, where he's talking about his father.
Yeah.
And saying how, man, I thought the art came before everything, but you was hurt by the things I said.
Mm-hmm.
I should have came to you first.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? That's vulnerability, G.
It's vulnerability.
You know what I'm
bro.
Saying? Like, he's a very open artist, G.
Yeah.
He talks about how his son got autism. He believes from immunizations, G. Mm-hmm. He say that a couple times in his album.
Yeah.
I've heard my friends say the same thing. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
He got a lot of ideas in his album.
Yeah, he does,
G.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Even the cover of
a dollar bill,
Bernie.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? It's the allegory of the caveman theory. You know what I'm saying? I forget what that is. You know what I'm saying? But it's like the caveman is in the dark. He don't know what's out there. I forget exactly what it is. And I got to read up on that to understand that idea. But I felt where I like the album.
Yeah.
I like the album.
I do. Me too.
Yeah. I like the album. And I think it's one of his better projects.
Yeah.
But all his projects got like 20 songs on it.
Yeah.
He be working.
He does work. He's from that era.
All his albums got like 20 songs on it.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Can we give a shout out to Eddie P in the background, killing it right now?
He's doing his thing.
Doing his thing on spinning the
wheel. You know what, man? The fact that he's doing it, I feel like our conversation is.
I'm not gonna lie, Ed. When we at your house doing these shows more often with you in the background, now you know you started it.
Right.
This joint, look, this joint live.
Not to be on camera.
This joint live, G. I'm feeling this whole vibe right now, G. So, beers and bars.
Beers and bars.
Ed, you got us toasted up since you on the show too. You know what I'm saying? We'll see y'all next time, man.
Peace.